My courtroom is the biggest one in the building. I sit up on a bench. The case comes in with a mother who's recently given birth. The parent is right in the middle of the court and actually directly opposite me.
6 days postnatal, be asked questions, be asked to explain myself and articulate myself. Absolutely full of hormones, full of breast milk, bleeding through my underwear.
At the other end of the row, there'll be the local authority lawyer, and behind the local authority lawyer, there'll be the social worker.
You're going to be worried that a child who you have a responsibility for is going to be harmed. What you shouldn't be doing is leaving a child in a highly risky environment.
I can see the mother of the newborn. I can see the look on her face. I can see the distress that she almost inevitably is under. And that's very powerful.
Here in the courtroom, a judge will decide the future of a newborn baby. The stakes couldn't be higher. At its simplest, there are four things that can happen. The first will see the child go home with the parent. In the second, a family member will take care of the child. Third, a foster placement will be arranged. Or, most drastic of all, it will be agreed that the child should be adopted.
You balance the rights of the other participants in other ways, but the child's welfare is paramount, and that is the single guiding principle. That trumps everything.
And it's absolutely right that the welfare of the child should trump everything else. But, and this is a big but, over the last 10 years, the number of cases reaching this potentially life-changing situation has more than doubled. And almost half of those cases will end up being separated from their parents. That's a staggering increase in the state's intervention in family life.
What we shouldn't do is put our need to keep families together over in the need of a child's safety. So what we wouldn't want to do is leave a child in an unsafe situation where especially a newborn is particularly vulnerable if there's immediate risk to their safety.
I'm Nigel Richardson. I've got over 30 years experience working in and around the child welfare system. And most recently, I was the Director of Children's Services in Leeds. So what's changed in the last 10 years to have put twice as many newborn babies at risk of significant harm? Because that's the threshold professionals are working to. Has suffered or is likely to suffer significant harm. And they're all guided by a brilliant piece of legislation that's been around for 30 years.